Hello and welcome to the part 3 of control system MCQ series. The details of the question can be found in the description. So here in question number 1, it is asked the Routh array is prepared from. So the Routh array is used for finding the absolute stability of system, and it is obtained from the characteristic equation of the system. So for this question, first the answer is option number 2. For second question, with a negative feedback, the system gain and stability respectively will be. So whenever the negative feedback is given, its gain is reduced and its stability improves. So from the given options, this will be your first option is the correct. The system gain will reduce and stability will increase. For question number 3, it is asked that a system which is having 14 number of poles and 2 number of zeros, its high frequency asymptote in its magnitude plot shall have the slope of. So this question is from the board plot, and given values are number of poles are 14 and number of zeros are given as a 2. So asymptotic plot of board plot will be having a slope of plus minus 20 dB per decade. Positive side is sign is used for the zero frequencies, and negative sign is used for the pole frequency. So single pole or single zero contributes the 20 dB per decade. So if you by following by convention and the number of poles and zeros given, if you solve it, you will get the result minus 240 dB per decade. That will be the slope of this asymptotic plot. For question number 4, the value of K for which the unity feedback system, unity feedback means HS is given and that value is 1. GS is given K over S, S plus 2, S plus 4 crosses the imaginary axis. This question is from the root locus. So as a step number 1, we will find write its characteristic equation. So 1 plus GS HS, this is our characteristic equation of system, and it will be of third order. So now making Routh array starting from S cube up to S0. So this value you can evaluate by multiplying these elements and divided by this element. So for the system to this root locus to cross the imaginary axis, we will equate this S to the power 1 row to 0 to find the value of gain K, and that value will be 48. So for the question number 4, the option is 4 is correct. In question number 5, the characteristic equation of a system is given, and we have to comment on the stability considering the value of gain K. Now to find the value of K, we are framing the Routh array. So from S square to S of 0, and to find this element, you will multiply this term minus 0 divided by this. This will result in 2k minus 1. Now for system to be stable, this first column sign, all signs should be same. So considering them as a positive, so 1 is positive. For this value to be positive, it should be greater than 0. And 2k minus 1 should be greater than 0. So k should be greater than 1 by 2. So this question number 5 will be having correct answer as option number 4. Next, for question number 6. If the characteristic equation of a system is given, we have to comment on the stability. So as a short trick, you should always know that for a system to be stable, the characteristic equation must have all the signs as a similar. So if you observe, you are having one negative sign, so you can directly comment, you can directly write the answer system is unstable. For question number 7, for a second order system with closed loop transfer function is given, it is a second order system, and the setting time for 2% band, so this 2% is a tolerance band. Whenever a system for a second order system is given as a unit step input, it exhibit like this kind of response, and this time is known as the time taken here, it is known as the settling time or setting time. For the 2% tolerance band, the value of time is 4 over delta omega n, and by comparing with the standard equation from the characteristic equation that we obtained by comparing the denominator term to 0, you can find the value of natural frequency and damping ratio as 0.6 and 5 radian per second. By putting these values in this TS 4 over delta omega n, you will get the value of a setting time equals to 4 by 3. So for question number 8, which one of the following effects in the system is not caused by the negative feedback? So there is reduction in gain with the application of negative feedback, there is increase in the bandwidth, as well as there is reduction in noise. So this option is correct, there will not be increase in the distortion for question number 8. Question number 9, the transfer function is given, which is 1 plus 0.5s over 1 plus s. We have to comment from the pole zero plot which type of network it represents. So if you draw the pole zero plot, there is one pole at minus 1 and one 0 at minus 2. So whenever you see this kind of pole 0 pattern, if pole is nearer to the origin and this kind of arrangement you find, this kind of network is always known as the lag network. Moving on to question number 10. The open loop transfer function of a unity gain negative feedback control system is given. GS is given, and we have to find the angle theta at which the root locus approaches the zero of the system. Now, to solve these kind of problems, we have to first draw the pole zero plot of given system function. And if you observe here, there are three poles which are marked in red, and there are two zeros which are marked in the green. So the zero location are at minus 2 plus minus j2, and the poles are existing at 0, minus 2 and minus 8. So the procedure is to connect all the zeros and poles, and then use this relation summation of p minus summation of z, that is equals to 180, and this p and z are the angles representative with reference to their poles and zeros. So this summation will include all the poles angle, and this will include all the zeros angle. So if you put the values of theta 1, theta 2 and theta z, which is angle with the zero, which is unknown, so if you solve it, you will find that this option number 4 is the correct answer. This will be 45. So this will be tan inverse 1 by 3, and you can find the angle of this given question. Next, question number 11, the gain margin of system is to be obtained. Now, by gain margin, we mean that it can be obtained using this relation, which is 20 log 1 over mod of GH at PCO. PCO is the phase crossover frequency, the frequency at which the angle of system becomes 180 degree. These kind of problems it should be solved with the help of polar plot. So if you draw the polar plot, you will observe that the graph does not cut the minus 180 degree axis. So for this given question, the gain margin of system will be infinite. Next, for question number 12, the transfer function of system is given. Input given is sine omega t, and we have to find the steady state output. Now, by steady state, using final value theorem, you can observe that when time is tending towards infinity, S will be tending towards 0 and it will be SFS. Now, the transfer function of system can be obtained using this closed loop canonical basic form. So it will be GS over 1 plus GS HS. Putting the values of GS and HS is 1. So you will obtain this output C. For the sine omega t, the transfer function in Laplace domain will be omega over S upon S square plus omega square. Now, solving for this and putting S tends to 0, this will result in omega square equal to 9. So considering frequency plus 3, so this will be 3 radians per second.